The painting that I picked is called The Peaceful Kingdom by Edward Hicks. This painting was painted between the years of the 1830s and the 1840s. If you would like to see it in person, it is in display in the Brooklyn Museum of Art. Edward Hicks was a very religious person. He became a minister and became part of a religious society group of friends. This was a Christian group of people. The word friends also refers to Quakers. They all believed in a peaceful and simple life. To the left of the painting, we have Native Americans and another group of people having a discussion of some sort. They are surrounded by nature. In addition, a body of water is near them. To the right of the painting, we have animals and children combined together. You have a bull in the middle of the canvas. To the bottom of the bull, you have a mole. At the bottom of the mole, there are two children. Next to the children, you have a leopard. And next to the leopard, you have a black bear. Next to that black bear, you have a bull. To the top of the leopard, you have a mountain goat, and next to the mountain goat, you have a baby cow. To the top right of the painting, you have a child with its arm around a tiger. At the bottom of the tiger, you have a wolf and a sheep. Next to the child with its arm around the lion, and to the right of the picture, you have two cows. The focal point of this picture are the animals and children gathered together because it shows unity. The painting on the canvas is polychromatic because Edward Hicks uses more than one color to paint on this canvas. To the top left of the painting, you can tell that the canvas goes from light to dark really fast. This is called tenebrism. This painting is asymmetrically balanced because it has two visually balanced sides. Edward Hicks painted over 72 different paintings of the Peaceable Kingdom. And here are just a few of the paintings that he's painted out of the many. Since Edward Hicks was a religious person, the Peaceable Kingdom was based on a biblical passage from the book of Isaiah. The wolf shall dwell with the lamb, and the leopard shall lie down with the kid, and the calf and the young lion and the fatling together, and a little child shall lead them. This was an interpretation of Christianity, a prediction of Christ's coming. To the left of the picture, there are Native Americans in the background. They are having a treaty with William Penn. Both Native Americans and William Penn man even grounds to be able to gain a trusting relationship with each other. Edward Hicks was inspired by the Quaker William Penn and his treaty with the Indians, which is visible here in his paintings, The Peaceable Kingdoms. Edward Hicks used this as a metaphor to incorporate an expression and the concept of peace in all of the different paintings that he created of the Peaceable Kingdom. Since Edward Hicks was a religious person as well, he became part of the Quakerism group, which are people that try to live in communities that are peaceful. William Penn was an English leader for Quakers. The Peaceable Kingdom exemplifies the Quakerism idea. In this painting, it shows you many kinds of animals, but the two that stand out in particularly are the lion and the lamb that are laying down right next to each other. The fact that the animals are in their comfort zone and the lion is not attacking the lamb shows you how they are superior to each other. The fact that the animals are in their wild shows you the fault of humanity. The fault has to be controlled in order to live in a peaceful place. The Peaceable Kingdom by Edward Hicks was about what he thought was important, which was peace and unity. He used the animals and children to show unity, and he used the treaty in the background to show peace. Here I have my artwork. Edward Hicks' painting was about what he thought was important. He encouraged me to make a collage of what I thought was important. And to me, my family is important. I created a collage of pictures of my immediate family, which is my mother, my brother, my father, and my sister. I decided to pick the pictures of when we were younger because I believe that we have many memories, and with these pictures that we have of when we were younger, we're able to cherish and carry them throughout our lifetime. In the middle of my collage of pictures is a very important picture to me. It has all five of us, and I wanted that to be our focal point because all of them are important to me. Here I have three challenging questions for you guys to answer about the painting The Peaceable Kingdom by Edward Hicks. Question 1. How many paintings did Edward Hicks paint of the Peaceable Kingdom? A. 70. B. Over 72. C. 75. Question 2. What biblical passage was the Peaceable Kingdom based off of? Question 3. What group did Edward Hicks become a part of? Thank you for watching.